I grew leery of the cold Atlantic. Others saw it as a means of transportation, perhaps to warmer climes or exotic lands. I knew it as a great petulant monster, waiting to catch a sailor unaware and devour him, spitting his bones into the reef, his dreams into the great abyss. Imagine my relief as a young boy to discover that behind the lighthouse the land stretched out as far as the sea. The idea of grass, trees, and mountains filled me with a joy that was unexplainable. I set my eyes towards the west, and the great plains, where the only waves were grain. The lighthouse had other plans. It enveloped me and clung like tentacles, coaxing me to linger beside the bay. Firmly planted at the base of the old building, I grew into a man on this jetty of land, never venturing beyond the first set of hills that rose from shore. It was only natural I took over from my father when his eyesight failed, after searching the sea for decades. It wasn't until Father died and Mother moved to Illinois to live with her sister that loneliness struck me like a rogue wave. What was once a soothing aria, the foghorn sounded like a bleating goat on its way to slaughter, and the great light itself seemed puny and helpless, reaching across the waves into oblivion. Had I not met her, I would have surely resigned my job and moved inland, perhaps follow my mother to her side of the family, deeply ensconced on the prairie. She came to me one summer day, sketchbook in hand, a beautiful girl, perched on the rocks, drawing the handsome features of the lighthouse. There was something about the breeze, ruffling her hair, and bare wet feet peeking out of the hem of a billowing skirt, that sent me out the door, pushing through my habitual shyness to approach her, offering a tour of the landmark. Later, we sipped tea on the front beneath the spiral staircase. Her name was Isabel. I was enchanted. She smelled of salt water and offshore breezes, ebony hair tangled about her face like seaweed, as Isabel spoke of the ancient Atlantic like an old friend. We talked of seals and latitudes, tides and pelicans, her green eyes glowing with delight. I felt my heart lift and spiral up toward the light, wishing the afternoon would never end. But alas, it did. She rose at high tide with promises to come back again. That night, I barely slept, then spent every waking hour for days thinking of her, peering through the windows and searching. When Isabel returned, summer had gone, and with it any warmth. Autumn began to build, and early snow spitting against the rocks and windows. She appeared at the cottage door as though she had never left, her damp hair, her skirt dripping. Again, we spent hours talking of the sea, of dreams. I knew without a doubt that this was the woman I wanted for all eternity. Her visits became more and more frequent, and we fell in love.